Referee.
Well, he's been refereeing that long?
Yeah, former amateur fighter himself.
Nice.
Says he's officiated in the thousands. Wow. In the thousands now.
Seen it all. Done it all.
MMA, boxing.
And here we go.
Pistol Pete's last bout was a TKO against Wilfredo Buelvis just down the road in Weston, Florida.
Before coming over here, I did watch his last fight, and he looked phenomenal. Those straight right hands he landed on his opponent would have gotten anybody out of there. Oh, goodly left hook. I like watching Peter. Very methodical, very patient. Picks his shots.
And I believe you mentioned he's been boxing since shortly after he started to walk.
No, he actually started boxing at the age of 16.
It was a 16, I
yes.
thought, okay.
No, at the age of 16. A former fighter saw him and said, hey, you're the goods. Andres moving around, get warmed up, fill out process. Pitufo, what he goes by, is coming off a TKO loss to a prospect in his last fight. But he says he came in overly confident, and that was his downfall. He won't commit the same mistake in this fight versus Peter Dobson. Pistol Pete.
Pistol Pete Dobson. What's up, guys?
What's going
Welcome
on?
Welcome back, Johnny Faraci. We have Vieira here in the white trunks, and we have Pistol Pete in the gray and navy trunks.
Yeah, the New York Yankees outfit colors.
Oh, yeah, he's repping New York City.
Another boogie down Bronx fighter showing up here in Hallandale Beach. Pistol Pete, like you mentioned, Will, his last fight, he was letting those right hands go, and he turned the pistol into a shotgun that night.
Yeah, he did. Mm-hmm. I literally jumped out of the seat when he caught that, his last opponent with those right hands.
Strong,
right
too.
On the button.
We were literally ringside, and we felt those.
Andres is not doing much this round. I don't know if that's the game plan, because he did fly in kind of late, jumped right on the scale and made weight, and now he's fighting tonight.
You know, you say that, and that's absolutely true. He literally drove right from the airport to the scale.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And there's a calmness in Dobson, too. There's not a lot of unnecessary movement.
No, not at all. Not at all. You can see he's well-trained, which he's training now at Beta Bay Boxing in Hollywood, Florida, with a hell of a trainer, Jeff
Porras, and also Kevin Gleason there at the gym. It's the same gym Blake Davis fights out of. And those guys have been definitely churning out champions out of that gym now for a minute.
And Peter might be the next one. Mm-hmm. No wasted motion. Stays right there in the pocket.
Yeah. And to the contrary, Vieira is doing quite the opposite. I see a lot of movement, but I don't see a whole lot of effective movement.
I feel it's a bit of anxious movement more than it is.
And like I said before, he's coming off a TKO loss. He might not be sure of himself.
Could still be in his head.
It still might be in his head, correct.
Beautiful Anna Sophia letting the crowd know it's round number two here at the Sporting Kings Theater. DJ Kong rocking the AC/DC. Jeff Porritz in the corner of Pistol Pete giving him instructions. I'm sure
and for those watching us, I hope they don't forget, Andres has a solid record. 10-3, 8 by knockout.
Yep.
But those three losses, he's been stopped. That's the only problem.
Yep. Will, what does your unofficial scorecard look like after round number one?
Oh, 10-9 for Peter Dobson. Yep. Easy. Yep. Controlled everything. Every aspect of the round.
Round number two.
Scheduled for 6 rounds. Okay, now Andres, he's starting to move forward.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, he quit moving back, Being part of his plan. Show him some feet in the first round and stand in the pocket in the second and see.
And which I understand, you don't want to get clipped early with a puncher like Peter Dobson, 13-0, 8 by knockout.
Right.
So I understand what Andres is doing in the first round.
I think in most fights that Peter Dobson wins the fight in the pocket, though, he's great inside.
Vieira still has some kind of jumpy, jittery movement that seems more, like you said, Johnny, out of nerves than by strategy.
Yeah, I do see a lot of movement from him, but when you're in with a puncher like Peter Dobson, you have to be careful because he can take your lights out at any moment.
Peter Dobson comes in 13-0 with 8 knockouts. He is slowly and swiftly transitioning from prospect into real contender, and he's right there at the cusp.
Great right hand. He hurt him.
Yeah.
Threw that right hand over a lazy jab by Andres.
And that got Andres going backwards now.
Peter stalking him now. And you can see that look in Peter's eyes. He's like, I got him.
Yep.
You can see it.
He's figured out his range for that right hand. But now,
hey, but you always have to be careful. Andres is no slouch. He's not a walk in the park.
Well, he got hit with that thing twice now, you know. Yeah. We'll see how we adjust to it.
And he didn't travel here from Uruguay to lay down either.
No.
No. Pistol Pete's slick move inside. Look at him.
Yeah.
Great judge of range there.
A good right hand. Andres pulling out that call with a short right hand by Pistol Pete.
Pete now found a home for that right hand a few times. Let's see if he follows up. Put something behind that.
We talk about a lot of movement behind Vieira, but I haven't seen a punch yet that really seems to have done any damage or really gotten Pete's attention.
Hey, and I know it's only the second round, and you can see what I'm seeing. Pistol Pete is cutting off the ring, but he's still giving him an exit. If he cuts the ring off a little bit more,
yes.
He'll cower, get him closed in, and might get the knockout.
And look at here, right at the end, Vieira lands a left hook. Not much in the way of all that Pistol Pete has done. Pistol Pete definitely won this round.
Yeah.
Vieira now behind 2 rounds on the card, I'm sure on your card, Will, as we end round number 2.
Yes.
Here at the Sport at Kings Theater, Hallandale Beach. Bad Promotions, only the strong survive. A new world title. Thank you, new world title. Thank you to all of our sponsors. Everyone that's tuning in worldwide, we got viewers all over. Appreciate you checking in. We're in the middle of Pistol Dobson versus Andres Vieira.
Schedule
3 coming up.
Schedule for 10 rounds. Into the third round.
Yes, I think there's a mix-up on the number of rounds that this is scheduled for. We may want them. I'm going to check that. The ring card, Daniela, does a little curtsy twist inside the ring. Here with this great crowd here. The heads up, it's round number 3. What a beautiful venue though, huh?
I love it.
It really is.
This is my first time here, man.
For a boxing event, this is absolutely gorgeous.
I've seen.
There's not a bad view in the entire place.
No, really not. They got the couches up here, the first row of all the couches. People are lounging around on the couches like it's their living room.
You know, I've seen boxing matches and bars and smoky banquet halls and even barnyards before. And you guys, Bad Promotions, always get the classiest places to put these on.
Credit to Bad Blake Davis and connecting those dots. He's the master. Right now, working inside there is Pistol Pete Dobson.
Good little short overhand right by Pete, El Pitufo, which means shorty in Spanish.
Ah.
Yeah.
So I initially heard Pity the Fool while I was thinking of Mr. T.
Pity the Fool. So what I like about Pete, he's putting leg pressure. For those that might not understand, you don't have to throw any punches. Make the guy move.
Yep.
Make him burn his energy. So I like what Pete is doing, using leg pressure, using feints, staying behind the jab. Very, 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 very impressed by his performance so far.
Andreas seemed like he may have leveled up a bit in this round. Well,
yeah, no,
taking
combination.
A few shots down, he's kind of coming forward a little bit. I think he's feeling the fact that he's falling behind. But it's really having a hard time.
Oh, good jab.
Yeah, it was a good job.
Dobson, a former New York Golden Gloves champion.
Yes, in 2010, right? Yeah, in 2010. It's not easy to win the Golden Gloves in New York City either.
Right?
And for Vieira, Dobson appears to be a puzzle he can't quite solve.
Not yet, but he's putting the pieces in. He's slowly figuring it out. He went to get that lead right, or that straight right hand back.
Well, Dobson is, I mean Vieira, doesn't seem to be able to figure out any key that fits here.
Yeah, I see him trying to, he comes out, stays put, then he starts moving. I don't understand the game plan. That's what I'm trying to figure out. I'm trying to probably make Peter Dobson fall into a trap, but I don't even see that either.
Those two straight right hands by Dobson just now might have been his best two of the fight. Great uppercut.
Uppercut, left hook, uppercut. I like that combination.
Dobson in complete control.
I have to agree.
Formidable opponent, though, I tell you.
Hey.
Vieira came.
Hey, he's coming. He's coming to fight.
He's just getting outgunned by Pistol Pete.
And it's just a small... if Peter... I'll repeat again. If he cuts off the ring, he'll be able to corner him and get more shots off.
I enjoy puns of that caliber, Johnny.
I see.
There we could be here all day with this, huh?
Round number three. Ludes. Here at the Sport of Kings Theater, Allendale Beach, Bad Promotions, Only the Strong Survive 2, the fourth event of Bad Promotions, and we're back at our home here. I'm with Bill Barner, Will Montero, and we're having a great time.
I honestly love it here. Horse racing, boxing, there's malls, I mean little shops that you can go, I can be here all day.
Yeah, Miami 10 minutes from you, Fort Lauderdale 10 minutes from you, oh yeah. Coming in.
We have Jeff Koritz and Kevin Gleason in the corner of Pistol Pete Dobson. And what is a corner man going to say when your fighter's out there and he's doing the right thing? He's in control of the man. What do you say?
I would say what Will was pointing to earlier, and then you got to start moving forward now and start cutting the ring off and getting this guy on the ropes.
And don't be relaxed. Don't be relaxed. Right. Continue doing. You got to stay sharp.
Right. Right. Don't get comfortable.
Don't get comfortable.
Right there, like you said, if he had stepped to the right and cornered him there, he wouldn't have got out of the corner there. Mm-hmm. But he's not cutting the ring off. Throws that uppercut there. He's going to find a home for that again.
Oh, good left hook by Andres. Yeah. Snap the head back of Pistol Pete. Andres coming out a little stronger this round. See, but this is what he does. So you'll see him, he'll come out, he'll get touched, then he starts going around the ring.
And Pete's real good at returning fire too, so if he does get touched, you know it's coming right back. Mm-hmm. Wow, what a beautiful three-piece. Mm-hmm.
And what I like about Pete, he changes speed, he changes power, and that only comes with experience and being comfortable in the ring.
Yep.
And you're starting to see it from Dobson, these combination punching now.
Yep.
Yes. Well, he's putting his punches together.
Well, I don't know if I am going to foretell the future, but I like that uppercut that he's landing. If he lands that clean, that could be big trouble for Vieira.
Yeah. No, he sees.
He found a home for that thing.
He sees Andres. He picked up on that. Andres leans forward.
Yep.
Pick him up with that uppercut.
There it is
again.
There
you go. There it goes again.
Knocked his mouthpiece halfway out.
Andres smiles.
You gotta love this. And then he takes a deep breath.
Okay, now he got him in the corner.
Yeah. Andres is feeling now right now like good. Bill Barner did when he wrestled that bear in a bar in Cleveland.
Outmatched?
Yes, outmatched.
Well, there's a lot less biting in this match, which is good.
Hey, and moving forward, this fight is, I think, at 154 pounds, but Peter Dobson moving forward will be campaigning at 147 pounds, a loaded welterweight division.
Yes. Yes, it was contract, I think, at 49.
Oh, 49. Okay.
The welterweight division has been hot for several years now.
For a very, very long time. Matter of fact, tonight we have a good fight with Dennis Ugas and living legend, 8th division world champion Manny Pacquiao.
Right. We should be all going to the after party to see that Errol Spence versus Pacquiao, but now we can go watch Hidenis Ugas and Manny Pacquiao.
Yo. My kids are at home watching Bianca Belair and Sasha Banks.
Interesting. I'd have to Google that, but
SummerSlam.
Oh, okay.
Oh, right on the bell, another right hand.
All right, some
end
James Brown. Some James Brown.
The end of four. Let's go to Will Montero's unofficial scorecard after four rounds. Will, how you have it?
Easy to score. 30-26 for Peter Dobson. Controlling every aspect of the bout. Jab, speed, combination. Moving forward, bring generalship. He's doing it all.
Well, you know, I can tell you on statistics and stats and everything else, so far you've been 100% on your scorecards?
Pretty much. Thank you very much for that compliment. I've been doing good on the scorecards, which is not normal.
Hey, well, you know, it just shows you know a little ish about boxing.
Oh, yes. Oh, no, I live this.
Yeah, me too.
I love it.
A couple of the people that we can thank for this event, too, we have Evan from Main Mix Productions doing the audio and video broadcast. And Z, our ring presenter from
Z Zamora. Z Zamora, he's the man. If anyone needs a boxing ring in the whole Southeast, you call Z Zamora.
Yeah.
I spoke with him as he was constructing the ring, and he was telling me the importance of keeping a tight enough top three ropes, but a looser bottom rope to avoid neck injury in the instance of a knockout. The lower rope has to have a lot more give.
It's funny because I've noticed a lot of the lower ropes have been loose lately. I don't know if it's always, but I was like, the lower, but I get that, yeah. If you bounce off that, yeah, you could. Here we go, round number five. And again, Vieira starts a round off kind of coming forward, and Pistol Pete, double jab there and a hook off it, sticking the hook.
Good shot by Andres, but Pistol Pete came back.
No, got him against the ropes finally. Okay, got him in a corner. That's where he's good. That's where he's gonna stop him. That's where he's gonna finish his fight, is in the corner on the ropes. And with that uppercut.
And as you mentioned, Will, he's Pistol Pete has effective aggression, but he does seem to give Vieira way out.
Every single time. I'm not frustrated, but he can end the fight.
Just close that door.
Just cut off the ring. That's it.
That one step to the right there. He's so strong.
Close that door he keeps walking out of.
Because he's doing everything right.
Yeah.
The only critique I have of him is he's not cutting off the ring. That's the only thing.
That's strong punches. These punches are starting to really find a home and knock the head back on Vieira.
Two sharp jabs by Dobson.
You know, all for whatever Pistol Pete is doing, Vieira's tough.
Yes, he is.
You know,
I'm not saying he's taking a beating like the first fight, but, you know, he's holding his own. He comes back, but he's a little bit outgunned.
Got in the corner.
Uh-oh. Oh, he hurt him.
He hurt him.
Yeah, he did.
Shotgun to the eye.
He goes down to a knee.
That may be it, because that really looked like it.
He's essentially giving himself a knockdown just to get an opportunity to decide if he wants to keep doing this.
Hey, hit him high in the head, knocked off his equilibrium. Did I say that right? Equilibrium?
It still looks like his leg. That's it. No, because I was going to say, it still looked like his legs were. Oh, there you go.
No mas.
Pistol Pete. We're taking a little break after this fight here. We're going to move on to the next one. Before that, so we're going to have the national anthem rocked out by yours truly.
On the ESP.
Yes, the purple one.
That's right.
And then after that, we'll bring out Bad Blake Davis. And that's going to be a hell of a fight. Tyler Fogle, Blake Davis. Blake Davis is hungry. He's wanting to show all of his fans here inside the Sport of Kings Theater that, you know, why they showed up, why they came out to support him, because he is Bad Blake Davis, and he gets to put himself on display again here.
For our listeners, all our boxing fans out there, a couple little pieces of boxing news. One, Gervonta Davis apparently was in a minor plane crash.
Oh, my God.
But he is okay. He is reported that he is okay, and they said it's a minor. I never heard of a minor plane crash.
Never.
But he apparently is okay.
All right, you guys, I got to go. I'll be right back.
All right, Johnny.
For both fighters, please. Ladies and gentlemen, from Gulfstream Park in Hallandale, Florida, your referee in charge, Alan Ebelis, calls a halt to the bout at 2 minutes, 15 seconds of round number 5. Your winner by TKO, still undefeated, Pistol Pete Dobson.
Well-deserved victory, propelling Pistol Pete to 14-0 with
9 by knockout.
9 by knockout. Also in boxing news, Don King turned 90 yesterday.
Oh man, a living legend, been in the game forever.
He was Ali's manager. He was Mike Tyson's promoter.
Yep.
Also celebrating a birthday yesterday, Connie Chung.
Who?
Connie Chung. Veteran broadcaster, Connie Chung, 75 years old.
Yeah, 75 years old. Okay, and I'm not even acting like I do. It just came to me. I know who Connie Chung is. Worked at NBC, didn't you?
Which Don King said.